This is video 38 in our series on analytical mechanics. The playlist for all the videos is at the website digital-university.org. In this video, let's consider the same problem that we solved in video number 37. And I'm going to try to approach it with a different methodology. Remember what the problem was? We had a bowling ball, and it was released with a linear velocity and an angular velocity, but the direction of the angular velocity is in the opposite sense to the linear velocity. And we showed in the last video that if the magnitude of V0 and omega0 is such that this inequality holds, that the ball will go into forward pure roll. And we could determine what the velocity of the ball was at the time it went into pure roll. We're going to do that again in this video, only unlike the last video, we're not going to use kinematics to solve our problem. We're going to use conservation of angular momentum. And here is how it goes. So let's say that this is the bowling ball, or it could be a bowling ball, or a billiard ball, or a marble. It's all the same physics, and it has an initial linear velocity, V0. This is a positive direction, this is negative, and it has an initial backward spin, omega0. And then as this slides across the surface, there will be a friction force in this direction. Now what we did in the last video, when we were using kinematics to solve the problem, we took the torque about the center of mass. In this video, what happens if we try taking the torque at about the contact point where the ball makes contact with the surface? Call that point C. What's that torque equal to? Of course, in general, torque equals a position vector, the cross product of a position vector with a force. In this case, the force is friction. But what is the position vector? The position vector is supposed to go from the point of interest to where the force is applied. But the force is being applied right here at that contact point C. So the position vector is zero. Consequently, the torque about point C, that must equal zero. That means then that the angular momentum about point C must be a constant. Say that because the time derivative of angular momentum, that equals the torque. But if the torque is zero, that means this derivative is zero. If that derivative is zero, that must mean that this is a constant. So we know that angular momentum about point C is conserved. Now, let's consider the angular momentum above point C at two different times. Initially, when the ball first makes contact with the surface, where it has V0 and omega0. We'll call that LC initial. Then we'll consider the angular momentum above point C. We'll call it final, when the ball goes into pure roll. And then at that point, it will have a final velocity, or the velocity at that point, we'll call it V final, and it will have angular velocity at that time. But now remember, when it goes into pure roll, it has to satisfy this equation. This we derived back in video number 30. So when it goes into pure row, these are not independent anymore. They have to satisfy this stipulation. But for to get us started, let's consider then what is the angular momentum about point C when we have V naught and omega naught. Let's determine what that is. Now, if you've watched the videos in this series, you know that angular momentum always has two components. In fact, we proved that back in video 19-C. And the two components, what are they? One component, it would be the angular momentum of the center of mass above point C. And the other component is always the angular momentum of rotation about the center of mass. So let's take the first component. We have LC-I1 for the first component. And that is the angular momentum of the center of mass about point C. Now we know in general that angular momentum equals a position vector, the cross product of that with linear momentum. So here, what is the position vector? Well, we have to go from point C up to the center of mass. That's just simply the radius of the bowling ball. So this is going to be the cross product of the radius vector pointing up. The cross product of that with, this in general is just mv, for as a general expression for angular momentum. Our particular problem, it will be mv naught. Let me get rid of this. But this cross product is real easy because these are perpendicular. So that's just going to equal mv naught times r. So let's write this in place of this. That's going to be the magnitude here. And again, the reason why we got that simple expression, these two are perpendicular to each other. The sine of 90 degrees is 1 when we take that cross product. Is it positive, though, or is it negative? So let's consider. Here was then there is mv naught in this direction, going to the right. But remember, when we take the cross product, we position the vectors like this. And then we want to imagine wrapping our fingers around this so that this vector is aligned with this one. So to do that, our thumb was pointing down. So we're pointing into the board, and our fingers wrap around like this. And that's a positive direction. It's the counterclockwise that is negative. So the first component of the angular velocity at C, that's a positive component. Now, the second component is always the same as we derived in video 19C. The second component, the angular velocity of rotation about the center of mass, that's always equal to the moment of inertia about the center of mass times the angular velocity. For our problem, initially, angular velocity is omega naught in the negative direction. So here we have the two components of the angular momentum see when the ball first makes contact with the surface. It is, so the total angular momentum is this minus this. So LCI equals this minus this. Now, what will be the angular momentum of all point C when we're in pure roll? What's with the same general formula? It's going to be M P final times R. It's going to have a different velocity. And if it's in pure roll, it means two things. If we're going to attain pure roll, this equation has to hold true. Plus, at the time of pure roll, then it's going to be, angular velocity is going to be in this direction, the same sense as its linear velocity. So that means when we're in pure roll for this term, it's going to be plus the moment of inertia times omega final. And what's more, this, because of pure rho, this equation has to be true. Omega final has to equal V final divided by R. So we can substitute that in right here. So, if the ball is going to go into pure roll at some time t, or t prime as we said in the previous video, then this has to be the expression for the angular momentum at the contact point C. So, initially, when the ball first made contact with the surface, the angular momentum at point C was this. Time of pure roll, it's going into pure roll, the angular momentum of point C has to be this expression. But now remember, from a few moments ago, we determined that the angular momentum of point C is conserved. It doesn't change. So that means that this expression must be equal to this expression. So let's make some room, write these equations at the top of the board, and then set them equal to each other and see what kind of an equation we get. So at about the contact point C, ball makes contact with the surface, that's where we're taking our angular momentum. Initially, we had this expression for it. That equal M V naught R minus the moment of inertia about the center of mass times omega naught. Then, if it's going to go into pure roll, at that point, the angular velocity or the angular momentum above point C equals the velocity at that time times R plus ICM. Now we have F over R. But angular momentum, as we showed at the beginning of the video, angular momentum about point C is conserved. So these two must be the same. So let's set them equal to each other. We have this. These two are the same values. So now we have this, because angular momentum is conserved. Well, point C is conserved anyway. This minus, and moment of inertia is 2/5 R squared M omega naught. And that must equal this expression. R plus 2/5 R squared M D final over R. Let me get a cancellation right here. Let's just write V final and take the 2 away. So we have this equation. We have MR, an MR term here, MR, and MR. So we can cancel here, 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 cancel the 2, cancel MR, and cancel MR. On this side we have V naught minus 2/5 R omega naught. And that equals V final plus 2/5 times V final. That is 7/5 times V final. Or V final. 5/7 and V naught minus 2/5 R omega naught, and multiply through, we have 5/7 V naught minus 2/5 R omega naught. That would be the velocity then when it goes into a pure roll situation. And that's exactly the same equation as we determined back in the previous video. I think that was video number 37. Only there we used kinematics to derive the equation. Here we used conservation of angular momentum, specifically conservation of angular momentum about the contact point C, where the ball contacts the surface. That's where we derived earlier that angular momentum about that point is conserved. And so once again, we get the same expression for what the final velocity of the ball will be once it goes into pure roll. Now, so it has to satisfy this equation. If we know what V naught and omega naught are, then of course we'll know what its final velocity is when it goes into pure roll. Now, what we'll do in the next video is we'll consider a very similar situation. We have, it could be a bowling ball or a billiard or a marble. Initial linear velocity, an initial backward spin. Well, now we're going to ask ourselves, if this skids forward and then just comes to a dead stop, what would have to be the relation of omega naught and V naught in order for that to happen? And that question we will answer in the next video.